Myself, SM Math, Assistant Professor, Walchand, Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today I am explaining through this video the orthopic projections. In the orthopic projections, next step of this one, that is a sectional view, we have to draw it here. Why the sectional view are to required? Because some surfaces have to be there, they are hidden one. They are not directly come into the surfaces. And when these surfaces not come to the surfaces, not in show, it is not clear that object, that part. So that's why you have to go for sections of this one. The basic learning outcome of this one is, student will able to draw the orthopic projections of a sectional view of the simple object. Now, here I am showing this object, this isometric view. So here you have to draw the front view in the direction of x, and a section you have to take on it here. Section, the section line is to be shown here, AA. This portion is to be there. From this portion you have to cut this half portion. Half portion you have to cut it, and you have to draw the section of this one. So first of all, you have to calculate the maximum dimensions in the direction of F. The maximum dimension is given as, it is R15 from the center line. 15 plus 15, that is a 30. From 30 plus 15 center line, 45. 45 plus, this is R15, that is a 60. So this length is 60, width is 60, and length, height is given as R15. 15, center to center distance 45. So 15 plus 45, that is 60. 60 plus 15, 75. So take height as a 75. Height is 75, and total width is given as 15 plus 15, 30, 30 plus 15 plus 20, 60. And the height is 75. So we make a block of this one. Okay. Now, this portion which is to be seen here, I am hatching up this one, this is a front view. But this portion you have to cut it here. But the hidden portion that comes into surfaces. Okay. So that part as seen as it is. So you have to go for a circular portion, R15 with a radius 15. So first you have to locate the center line of this one, this portion center line, this center and center matching one, that is R15. From this end you have to move 15 mm. Here and 15 mm from here. So, I have to complete this one, a semicircular part of this one. I take a diameter of radius as a 15. That is total width, total how much where it is extended. So this portion, this width is to be 10 mm. One more center line, the circular hole is to be there, matching one. That is to be given as 515. Four holes are there, 1, 2, 3 and 4. That diameter is 515. So radius is 7.5. This part is over. Now, this portion remaining, it is actually it is circle, it is perpendicular, it is a square block, and the width is given as a 10 mm. So from this end, it is a 10 mm. It is up to here. And how height is extended, how much it is extended, it is given that the center to center distance is 15, and this height is to be given as a 10 mm. So total height is given as 45. So 15 plus 45 center to center. This center is 45 from here. So from this center to center 45, it is to be here. And center of this one. So 45 divided by 2, that is 22.5. From the top surfaces, 10 mm, 2 mm, 22.5 mm. Here it is, the center mm. And this width of this slab is given as, it is given. How much it is? It is 10, 10, 10. So from the upward 10 mm and downward, it is 10 mm. So total width is, it is taken as a 5 mm and 5 mm from here and here. And extend this portion. Now, we need to take this portion is to be there. We need to see from this circular portion is seen as a rectangle. And how much it is, this line is extend up its square block. It is a square block is to be there. Okay. And center of there is hole. And this hole is to be hidden one. So draw how we have to show it. Suppose some portion is to be there that is not seen in the front view. The hole is there, surface is to be there. That is to be shown by which notation? Think over that. Pause the video and think over that. Yes. So when that this hole is hidden one, it is to be seen that surface is hidden one, that edge is hidden one, that is to be shown by a dotted line. So that's why we have to draw the two dotted lines for this end and this end, for this hole one. So two dotted lines are to be there with the center line. So first we have to fix the center line. Center line is, R is 15 mm. So from this end, you have to fix the center line, that is 15 mm. This to be here. And radius is given as, it is given as, four holes are there, 5, 15, that is 7.5 radius. And it is to be seen by dotted line. Okay, again here also for this edge or this surface, again it is a hidden one, again it is to be dotted one. So fix the center line. Center line is 15 mm, R15. And the diameter is 515, that is 7, radius is 7.5. Right hand left 7.5 and 7.5. They are to be shown by a dotted line. Okay, so this is a regular, what you call, orthopic drawings. That is a front view orthopic drawing. But you have to take a section of this one. So this portion is to be removed. You have to section of this one. So when this portion is removed, this surface again come, it's okay, as it is. It is seen as it is. But what about this portion? This slab is to be cut. And when a hole is to be cut, the edges of these surfaces, this edge and this surface, it's shown. It is seen as a dark one. Instead of a dotted one, it is a one surface is to be there, this portion. Then this surface, the circular portion is, again, it is perpendicular one. It is seen as a straight way. It is a rectangle one. And again, this edge, it is to be seen. Now, this slab is to be cut up to here, and this portion is top of that. So it is a continuous one slab is to be there. And this portion is one portion. Again, same thing. This circular hole, it is to be cut. That is not seen. This portion is to be seen. You have to cut this portion centrally. Again, these surfaces and this surface, they are to be seen as a dark one, the surfaces. So this portion is seen as a one continuous surfaces. We have to cut this one. So that portion you had, I'm showing here as a section one. So this surface come to here, the circular portion that come to the surfaces. that is again parallel to you. So it is a sectional front view. Okay, so when you know this one, then you have to go for so this, when we have to cut this portion, sectional front view is there. Now as it is regular, we have to go for the top view. In the top view, you get as the two rectangular slabs are there. Extend this one. Centrally, the circular portion is to be there. Take this radius of this one. How much this radius is given as, you get as a circular portion is to be here. And two slabs are there, two rectangles are to be there. So today, basic concept is to be to clear the sectional view of the cut portion is to be there. When you have to cut this portion, so this surface seen as surface of the cut portion, this circular portion seen as the one of the surface rectangle, and remaining the slab is to be cut. And when this front portion, this portion is to be removed, the behind portion comes to here, and that is to be seen as a front view. Okay, so this is all about the sectional front view. In the next lecture, we have to go for the sectional front view, top view, and the side view. So for this one, references I am taking as the Engineering Graphics 1 by Professor M. L. Dabade, by the Vision Publications are to be there. Thank you.